going to show you the best product on the market for monitoring your temperature and your humidity. Now, the humidity doesn't really matter. It's really your temperature. Now, I've tested all kinds of them. I've had this particular one for about 3-4 months. I've tested it for about 3-4 months. And there's other products out there. There's so many different ones that I've tested in so many different ways for months and months and months. And finally, I've done a video on just to monitor your temperature. It's not necessarily the exact temperature. The reasoning for this is just for if your hot tub craps out. So if you're out of town, you can check your phone and see if the temperature's dropped down. Now, if your hot tub trips out and it's at 104, and it depends on the temperature outside, even if it's like minus 30, minus 40, you got about 24 hours that hot, like that low of temperature. You got about 24 hours before everything starts freezing up because it's already hot, right? So it takes a long time. And it also depends on where your hot tub is, where it's sunk in, where's the wind coming from, if there's any wind. But this is a good way of, if you don't really use your tub too much, maybe you have a cottage and you just want to monitor it, just your temperature, instead of spending a lot of money on alarm systems and that. Now, I'll link this product down below, but I'll show you how to set it up, where to put it the best way. So I've tested it so many different times. Now, this system here, now I've tried it without it. You can buy it without it, but it's hard to monitor. It depends on how far your tub is. And if there's a wall in between, obviously there's going to be a wall if it's outside. So I found just get both of these so it picks it up better and it goes up to the cloud, whatever the cloud is. So I'll link this down below so you get both of these. And the only thing you don't get is the cord for this when you put it in your router. So you got to get the cord for this. And I'll also link that down below. Now we found four. Now this, don't look at what this pack is, because this particular pack, the Balboa BP only, they have a system that I have a video on that you could buy. And it's a little bit more expensive than this, but you can control it by your phone. But you have to have the Balboa BP. Now, I have a video on that too, but don't worry about that. I'm just, you know, it's any pack, right? So you get the sensor in, and what I do is I just get some 3M tape, and I stick it on top. So it depends on where the tub is, where your pack is, but I find that if you can stick it on the top with 3M tape, just stick it on the top like that. Nothing's in the way. It's kind of, you know, the heat's there. And so I find it's better right here. Or you can try to hang it. You can try to hang it off something. Put a string through there or whatever and hang it. But I find it's just simple. You just put some 3M tape or a little bit of hot glue and just right on top. Just stick it there like that. Just keep it like that. And then you're going to hook this up. And I'll show you in a second how to hook this up. Now, you gotta remember though, whatever the temperature is on your top side, say it's 104, it's gonna be off a bit because this is just picking up the temperature of the ambient heat that's underneath the tub. So it could be 105, 106, but that's not the point. The point is of this system, the way I'm gonna show you, the whole point is you can see if it starts dropping. So if you set it for, if you have your hot tub set for 104, and then all of a sudden, you know, and if you're on traveling or whatever, and it's down to 90, you're like, okay, I need to call somebody to go take a look at the hot tub. Because you know the temperature is dropping. So this is just to pick up the ambient heat that's outside of the tub. But it's a good way of monitoring it. And then there's humidity. So what I found is if your hot tub has no little tiny leaks underneath there, your humidity is going to be a certain level. And say your pump seal goes and it starts leaking water a little bit, well, the humidity is going to rise underneath the tub. So the humidity will pick that up. So again, if your humidity, say, is 20 or 30 underneath the tub, and all of a sudden you're like, man, it's at 60. Well, you know that something's leaking underneath there because humidity's just going to build up. So that's a good way of monitoring that too. what you do with this, you have to get the cord, and I'll link this all down below, the cord and everything. And all you do is you just plug it in, get your cord for that, and plug it into your router. Plug this in, and it's all you have to do. So what you do is just download the app. I'll link the app down below so you can download it. So there's the app there. So you push that. And there's I put in Fahrenheit. But you can change it all too. And it just monitors it all. So you just go here. And you can change it all. It's straightforward. As soon as you plug that all in. So you do the high limit. You don't worry about the high limit. You just put what your temperature is in your tub. So I just put 109, but you can put 104. And it says alert me. You can put alert me. Don't worry about the calibration. Relative humidity, I just put it on. I just don't put the high limit and the low limit. And the rest of it, you don't really worry about for underneath the tub, like dew point or the VPD. Don't worry about that. Humidity, don't worry about that. You're gonna monitor. It's monitoring the heat. But if you want calibration, like I said, don't worry about that. Back, and then it just monitors it. You can kind of go back and see this goes. That's day after day, but you don't have to look at this chart, because when you have the monitoring, when you monitor it and you put the alarm, then here, like mine, I had to shut it off because I was testing it, kept it going down. So I put it for 80 Fahrenheit. That's pretty warm. But that's what it's picking it up, because we're this close. But because it's going to be outside, and instead of a hit and miss, because sometimes you'd get signal and sometimes you wouldn't. This is all Wi-Fi. Don't watch this video and then go, oh, okay, I'm going to get something cheaper. I've tested the cheaper ones. I've tested the Bluetooth ones. Bluetooth is kind of in and out, and if you're out of town, it won't pick it up. So this is the best system that I found, and you know, it's a little pricey, I think, but this is the best product out there for what I need. So, and then when you plug this into your router, it's going to come up here. Okay, and there's my humidity there, and that's picking it up right here. But that's pretty hot, 80 right now. But like I said, like right now I know I'm in the house, and I know that 80 Fahrenheit 0.5 is a little off. It's off about maybe five Fahrenheit. But again, you're not looking for exact temperature. You're looking for the safety. You don't want your tub freezing. Now, if you're in Florida or California, you don't have to worry about this stuff. It's more for people in Canada and where you actually have cold weather. If this video helped you out, make sure you hit that like button down below, and then we'll see you on the next one.